But is there anybody out there that has had, you know, a divorce? Okay, then. You might be able to relate to this poem. It's called Contemplating My Ex. Now, I ain't one to hold a grudge, nor talk behind his back, nor mention my ex-husband's faults, nor qualities he lacks. But daydreaming has given me some ways to get revenge, like making me a voodoo doll and sticking it with pins. I could fry up some poison mushrooms, that should do the trick. And shrug my shoulders when he asked what made him so dang sick. If ever I get close enough to catch that ornery man, I'll rope him by the head or heels or any way I can. He wrecked my truck, he took my loot, he left me deep in debt. Oh, I wish I could forget. He kicked my dog, he sold my saddle, drank a ton of booze, and had the nerve to bet the ranch, then went ahead to lose. He said he was just practicing with his new 22, but shot my hat to smithereens, and it was dang near new. I'm lucky that the hat was on the hook and not my head, or I'd be lying in my grave, all stiff and cold and dead. He made a steer from our prize bull. An accident, he said. I don't know where they went. Oh, shoot. Doggone it. You know what? Well, it's gone. So, I guess you see divorcing him was what I had to do. We cut our losses, called it quits, and now, by gosh, we're through. And if he knows what's good for him, he'll mind his P's and Q's. Because if I get a chance to drown him, I might not refuse. Throw him in a trough of water, hold him down in there, and not let that two-timing swindler take one breath of air. Oh, I've got to stop these hellish dreams before they ruin my life. So maybe I'll just leave him to the wrath of his next wife. And if by some strange quirk of fate I marry up again, just shoot me if I couple up with another man like him. Sorry.